The following conversation was recorded later in 1994, after Reg was transferred to Maidstone Prison in Kent. On many occasions he was impatient and tense with me, but on this tape he's calm and reflective, keen to tell me he's discovered the secret of life and passed it on to a young prisoner, Bradley Allardyce, who he had taken under his wing. He's talking about his parents' anniversary and birthdays because I was co-writing a book with Chris Lambriano, who had been in prison as part of the so-called Kray firm, and needed to check an important date Chris had given me. Referring to Chris's daughter being in hospital after a dreadful accident, Reg shows that despite all the years behind bars, he's sensitive enough to have picked up on my wife's caring for other people. That Reg had never heard of Ken Follett astounded me, but as he says, with no hint of irony, I don't get much time for reading in here.
Hello, Robin. How you going?
Hi, Reg.
You okay?
Yeah.
You've been busy writing, have you?
Well, I get up at 5 o'clock in the morning and write till about half 10.
Well, I've been doing that since 4 o'clock this morning.
Have you?
Yeah, I did that till about 7:30.
Really?
Yeah, I make notes every morning. Yeah. I always get up about 4 o'clock and I make lots of notes and I discuss them with my friend in the morning of each day to start the day.
Yeah.
Because I share my thoughts and whatever projects I've got in mind and whatever, you know.
Is this with Bradley?
Yes, and that's what I do every morning.
What's he doing time for?
But 12 years for robbery with firearms.
Jesus.
But he's done it out of a sense of adventure, really, because he went to join the Foreign Legion and he had about 3 months training and he got chucked out for different reasons and he's very upset about that, and so he went on robberies for a sense of adventure rather than boredom, and unfortunately he ended up getting 12 years for it, but he's doing it well, you know.
How much
he's
has he
done? He's only 26 now. He's got about, unless he gets paroled, he's got about 3 or 4 years left.
Right.
But he's okay. He's quite happy.
Yeah.
I'm sorry to see the little baby, but she's getting slightly better, isn't she?
Well, she's out of intensive care, which
very
is great.
Good. You and your wife show a lot of concern for other people, don't you? I've noticed this.
Very much so, yeah.
Yeah. I've noticed this. Your wife in particular as well.
Yeah,
she's very good, yeah.
She's
nice to have time for other people, isn't it, eh?
Well, she's met Ronnie, you know. Ronnie liked her.
Yes, I understand. I can imagine why, yes. By the voice alone, you know.
Yeah.
It's very good anyway. How are you anyway?
Well, I'm struggling with this book because I need to speak to Chris.
Well, Chris's book.
Yeah.
It's very difficult writing a book, don't you think so?
Well, it's...
It either flows or it don't. Sometimes they flow and sometimes they don't.
Yeah, but when you can't get hold of him...
Yeah, it's very difficult.
Because of things like this.
Difficult at the moment due to the baby's illness, eh?
Reg, can I ask you something?
Certainly.
When was your parents' wedding anniversary?
I don't know, honestly. In the Eastern peculiar, it may seem we didn't go on that type of thing too much, you know, it just wasn't too important. I don't think so at the time, anyway, as far as I recall.
Right.
You know?
Or your mum's birthday, I meant, actually.
4th of August.
Oh.
4th of August.
I had a feeling it was that, because he's told me something that happened, and I just didn't think it was the time, you know. But how's Peter Gerard getting on with your book? Because I spoke to Laurie.
Yes.
And I got the impression that he hadn't done it.
It's a long way from being finished, put it that way.
Yeah.
It's a long way from being finished.
Is he a journalist then?
Pardon?
Is he a journalist?
No, he's not a journalist. He's written some books on animals, you know?
Yeah.
I don't think he's done much of it, I don't know. But I'm finding it very difficult because I've told most of what there is to be told and I find it difficult to dig down any deeper.
I think you've got a great story still to be told in you.
Fortunately or unfortunately, whatever way you look at it, as each day goes by, there's always some more stories cropping up.
Yeah.
And in the last couple of days, I've reached the conclusion on three things, right?
Yeah.
It took me 60 years to realise this, and I just told my 26-year-old friend upstairs so he learns it quicker than I do, or did, I should say.
The three things
that you should be concerned about, and nothing else really, your health, your friends, like as long as you've got good friends, and peace of mind.
Yeah.
And that's the most you can ask for of a lifetime, I would think. I think they're the most three important factors. Myself, you know, I'm you're off your friends and peace of mind.
Have you got peace of mind?
Well, to a point, but not entirely, you know, because every day I get problems every day. What it is, I mix with lots of people, even though I'm in here, I'm in touch with lots of people, and so I'll get more problems. If I only had two friends, I would get less problems, but the more friends you get, the more problems you get.
Yeah.
It works both ways. They can help you or they can hinder you, you know? And so each day unveils another story for me, you know?
Yeah.
So really,
the story of your life in prison is a possible bestseller, in my view.
Would be a bestseller?
Well, possibly.
Oh, yeah, no doubt about that. It's not possibly, it will be.
Well, I always say possibly because in life nothing's guaranteed.
No, I agree there, yes, I agree with you there.
You can think you've got the most surefire
winner.
Yeah,
I agree. Well, there's no recipe for anything. There's no recipe for a bestseller, is there?
No. The most unlikely things make it.
Yes. Who knows what the recipe for a bestseller is? No one knows. If we did, we'd all be millionaires, wouldn't we? Eh? Right?
Have you ever heard of a writer called Ken Follett?
No, I can't say.
No. He wrote Eye of the Needle. Have you heard of that?
No.
All right.
Was he good?
Well, he used to work for me, and I used to pay him about £8,000 a year in 1970.
Yes.
He's worth £24 million now.
What kind of writing did he do?
Well, he's he's like a Freddie Forsyth thriller writer.
Oh, yes, very good, yeah. He must have a lot of good imagination.
Yeah. Have you heard of a book called The Key to Rebecca?
No, I'm not into much reading these days. I've read a lot over my sentence, but I'm not into it now. I don't get time for reading.
No.
There's a good one on the SAS recently, wasn't there?
That's right, yeah.
No, on the, what you call it, Iraqi War. I forget what it's called. I've got a copy upstairs somewhere.
Something about Romeo or Operation Zero or something.
Operation Zero, that's the one, yes. Anyway, it's nice meeting you, Robin. I'll phone you from time to time.
We seem quite relaxed now. We're not having a row.
Yeah. Well, I value you as a friend anyway. Oh, even though we've had our differences, I value you as a friend. And I hope you do me anyway.
Yeah.
What's happened to that?
I think you're very straight.
Thank you. Well, what's happened to that money? Would that be going to them children's mothers or what?
I told you this the other day. Laurie's got it.
Oh, yes, okay. So
did you know that I know Laurie?
I didn't know that you knew him. No, I didn't know
him. I've known Laurie for about 10, 15 years.
Well, he's a smashing fellow, isn't he, eh?
Very nice.
Please.
Sorry, I've known him for about 20 years. What am I talking about?
That's amazing.
You know, he had the speakeasy?
Yes.
I met him in the 70s.
That's amazing, yeah.
We've been out to dinner at that Chinese, with good friends in Stepney, and I've been to his house in Aston Street.
Did you ever eat at the Lotus S?
Pardon?
Did you ever eat at the Lotus S?
Yeah, in London. Edgware Road, yeah.
Oh, it's beautiful. It's smashing food, eh?
Yeah.
Anyway, I'll catch you another time, eh?
Okay, Rich.
Thank you.
Thanks for ringing.
Give your wife my love. Cheers.
Okay.